This episode of the Young Turks is brought to you by Gamefly. Go to gamefly.com/TYT for your free trial membership.
All right, the biggest science-related story in the news today has to do with NASA scientists that found microbes in a lake in California that basically has arsenic in its DNA. Mm-hmm. So why is this relevant? It's relevant because previously scientists believed that all living things are composed of six elements: carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, and phosphorus, right? However, these microbes are composed of arsenic.
Instead of phosphorus.
So it's a huge deal because all of a sudden they're like, so it turns out that some living things could be genetically different than other living things.
Basically.
Yeah.
We have a new life form.
And I meant
Abemus papam.
We do. It's a new life form. Everybody's going crazy over it.
That's biochemically different.
That's right. But it is still life. It meets the other definitions of life. Here's the only person in America not surprised by this news story. Me. Mm-hmm. Okay. I always thought that scientists saying, no, life has to be like this. And they would talk about it in the context of other planets, too, that you need a certain amount of water, you need it to be a certain amount of distance from its sun, et cetera, et cetera. I was like, no, you don't. I bet that there's a million, trillion different versions of life. Just because we're made of phosphorus, oxygen, et cetera, doesn't mean that other life forms have to be. That is a preposterous presumption, right? As we're going to do in the next story, there is sextillion, 300 sextillion stars in the world, in the universe, right?
In the universe, yes.
Yeah, you're telling me that all the life forms resemble the life forms on this planet? Hell no. And now we find out all the life forms on this planet don't resemble one another.
Right. And look, to be fair, a lot of scientists have the same thought process as you do. However, they didn't have any evidence until now.
Scientists with their evidence.
So now they finally have evidence, and it's a big deal because now they're thinking, well, this means that there could be life outside of our planet that live on different elements, different chemicals, and they're able to survive.
So if you don't need phosphorus, maybe you don't need oxygen. Maybe you don't need hydrogen. Okay, I mean, those are the different possibilities. Right now, to our mind, it seems really hard to conceive of that within our context, right? But to me, maybe you don't need any of them, okay? And so, with all the planets out there, are there other life forms? Of course, it would be absurd if out of the trillions upon trillions upon trillions of stars and planets that, no, we're the only ones who got it on lockdown, okay? So, and I'm not at all surprised that they found this, and I'm not at all surprised that there's other life forms in California. Okay. So, but it's a great breakthrough, and it really opens up a whole universe, if you will, of new possibilities. So it's a great day for science.
It is a great day in science. It's very exciting. Cenk, people don't know this about me, but I'm an underground gamer. I love to play video games.
Well, then you're going to love our new sponsor, Gamefly. They're the largest online video game rental service in the world. 7,000 titles, new and classic. Also, no late fees, no due dates. Shipping's always free.
Go to gamefly.com/TYT for a free trial membership.